Hello, everybody. Dr. Laura Ricci here. I wanted to talk about a really important topic that has been coming up over and over about organic versus pure with essential oils and how they actually don't mean the same thing. So we're going to dive deeper and talk about this and dispel some myths, because sometimes people ask me, why are doTERRA oils not considered organic? So we need to go into a deeper discussion about this. Many traders and consumers equate purity to organic, but they don't mean the same thing. Essential oils labeled as organic may have been contaminated during the processing, improperly distilled, or they could be extracted using chemicals or solvents. That is not a pure essential oil, and that's not an essential oil that we're going to be using for therapeutic purposes. So how you actually find a therapeutic grade and pure essential oil is you want to dig deeper and do the research, because unfortunately the burden is left on us as consumers. There's no governing agency that's regulating quality and purity of oils. And about 98% of the oils on the market are adulterated. They have some kind of synthetic fragrance in there. They could have heavy metals or pesticides. So we have to dig deeper as consumers. You want to find a company that actually has expertise in the distillation process, and they use innovative distillation equipment, a company that has published essential oil research in scientific journals, and that they actually take a clinical approach to essential oil development. You want to find a company that is personally involved in the farming and the cultivation process. They're going to inspect the farms. They're going to see that the plants are grown and harvested in their natural habitat. And a company that verifies purity with their own laboratories. So they are third-party lab testing facilities, and they have educated scientists that actually read and interpret these test results to make sure that they're free of fillers, pesticides, contaminants. A company with oils that smell like natural plants and whose single oils, they vary in aroma a little bit from batch to batch because there's an inherent variation in plants. So that's a good indicator that Mother Nature created that essential oil and that it wasn't created in a lab. So for example, if you pick up a bottle of oil and you smell it and it smells the same every single time, it was probably made in a lab. It's probably adulterated. So when you go to the health food store or the grocery store and that smells the same, I notice with mine, there's little bitty differences of one peppermint to another or one frankincense to another, because plants are a little bit different, just like we are as people, right? So they shouldn't be smelling exactly the same every single time. And you want to find a company that is willing to share the results from the tests that their essential oils have undergone to make sure that they are pure, that they're being authentic, that for that specific batch of oil that you purchased, that you know what you are buying. Because if you're not doing that, and if that company's not doing that, you're placing blind faith in them. And they could be using a product that doesn't meet high quality standard testing. So especially when we're talking about therapeutic use, inhaling something, putting it on topically on the skin, or even taking it internally, we want to make sure that it is pure. So I have seen a lot of oils at the health food store that say USDA organic on that label, but you flip it over and say it's something like orange oil, and it says not for internal use. If ingested, called poison control. That is not a pure oil. So a lot of people ask me, are doTERRA oils organic? So many of doTERRA's essential oils are certified organic. Others are EcoCert, and some do not have any certification. And the reason for this is because we source so many oils from developing countries. And the certification requirements and availability, they differ from country to country. So some countries, they don't even have a certification offering. They can't even do that. Or it may cost $2,500 for a grower to receive organic certification in, say, Madagascar. But this certification only lasts for 2 years. And most of the time, an inspector doesn't even go and visit that site. So nobody's verifying that it is really growing organically, that they're doing what they're supposed to do. The fee is what matters here. However, most of the growers in this impoverished country, they can't afford the certification, although they are all growing by the same standards. So there's no pesticides that are used, there's no herbicides that are used. So that's the reason why doTERRA has actually chosen not to print certified organic or EcoCert on our labels, because each has different certifications. Like some of our ylang-ylang may come in with an organic certification, and another lot may not have that certification, that organic certification, but those two lots may meet the very same quality standards with that. They go through the same battery of tests, and they are both certified not to contain pesticides, herbicides, fillers, synthetics, or any natural compounds with that. So I think that's really important for us to understand that one producer simply paid a fee to be certified organic and one maybe did not. But when we say that our oils are better than organic, that's what we mean. It's because we have the ability to see even the smallest component in a lot of oil. If there's anything that is contained in that oil that is not naturally produced by nature with the plant, it's rejected. We are not going to use that. So that's the big difference. That's why we have certified pure therapeutic grade, that CPTG process, because there was not a standard process. So doTERRA had to come along and create that. And that's what we do with this, by working with the growers and the farmers and the artisans. So to give you an example of this, we have a website called sourcetoyou.com. And you can actually go to that website and check it out. And I'll give you the example of, I have my bottle of frankincense oil. So this is my bottle of frankincense oil. On the bottom of the bottle of doTERRA's oils, there's a little code. So you can actually go and type it in. I just popped in that code. This is my code right here. It's 192074A on my bottom of the bottle of my frankincense oil. And you can see, and I can actually download the test results for my batch of oils. So this is a third-party lab, Aromatic Plant Research Center. For my batch of oil, that's the lot number right there. You can see when it was filled, you can see when it was tested, and you can go and see the chromatography and see that it has the natural compounds and the chemical constituents that we want. And at the end here at the bottom, it says, this analysis of frankincense lot has revealed no contaminations or adulterations. That is huge. So if you're not seeing that transparency from that company, you want to reach out to them and ask them. But this is the big difference. And I get asked this all the time, Laura, will I buy my essential oil at the health food store because it's organic? I get it. I understand. I love and purchase organic food. There is a difference between regular food and organic food. But when it comes to the world of essential oils, organic does not mean pure. And this is why. So we're going to dive deeper. We're going to ask better questions to get better answers. But I wanted to share this here to clear up any confusion around this topic. It's really, really important. Please do your own research. This is why, after me doing my own personal research, I chose to partner with doTERRA and pursue what's pure. Because what we're using in this bottle, especially if we're using it in our home, on our babies, with our family, putting it in our skin, or taking it internally, we want to make sure that that is pure. Organic, unfortunately, in the essential oil world, does not mean much. So I hope you found this helpful. Please share and pass it along with people. It's really important information, and have a great rest of your day. Take care, everybody. Bye.